Basic terms and definitions. One of the things that we have to establish is ability to communicate with each other. And these basic terms and definitions that we cover in this first chapter, we will be using throughout the entire course. And it's imperative that we be able to communicate with each other and amongst each other very accurately. First of all, let's talk about the idea of the population. The population is a collection of all objects of interest in a statistical study. So if we're doing something simple, like we're trying to figure out the average GPA is of students on campus, then the population would be all students on campus. Now that right away sounds a little bit vague, because on campus meaning what? Are you saying not including online students? Are you talking about students just this year or in the past 5 years and only at this campus, or could it be all campuses in California, all campuses in the United States, the Western region? See, you need to understand what population you're actually talking about when you collect data, and help ensure that you actually collect data from that population. So if we're talking about every student currently enrolled, say, this semester at this campus, that would be our population. All students currently enrolled on this campus this semester. So that would be a quick example of a population. Now, a census. A census is a complete enumeration of the entire population. And then information of interest is recorded from every object in the population. So in this case, if we're dealing with this particular population, by enumeration, what we mean there is we can identify every single element, in this case, every single student, and then population. That's what it means to enumerate. And then what we would do if we're going to complete a census is we collect information of interest, perhaps for GTA, their age, gender, whatever it is we're interested in doing, from every object. In this case, an object would be a student. So to complete a census, we would actually go to every student based on the way I define this population and get from them the information that we need. Now, right away, you should see that's probably very tough to do. Even if you have a small campus, it doesn't matter. Trying to truly get to every single person is a rough thing to do. Hopefully there may be records that are available that you could easily go to, but to actually physically go out and contact them, not a prayer. If you're looking for GPA information, well, that information should be in the records and you can get it. But if you want to contact every one of them and ask them who they're going to vote for in the next presidential election, well, that's not in the records. So you'd actually have to go out and physically contact each and every student. And good luck with that one. Now, because contacting every single element of population, and this is really a simple population I'm working with, because it's so tough to do, we normally work with what's known as a sample. A sample is a subset. And the way we define subset or think of subset is just a smaller, more manageable group. Now, if you've studied algebra, you know that a set is a subset of itself, but we're not talking about it in that sense. When we talk about data analysis, when we use the term subset, we're typically referring to the fact of we have a large population and we want a smaller piece of it that we can work with. Now, what's extremely important about this sample is that it's believed to be representative of the population. It needs to look like the population. Now, what that means, as an example, is if you have a population that has, I'm going to make up some numbers, say 73% are female. Well, you don't want a sample that has 27% female or even 50% female. Now, you may not get exactly 73%, but you want something close to that so that your sample is reasonably representative or it looks like your population. If you know what the ethnic breakdown is in your population, you want to help make sure that your sample is roughly matches that ethnic breakdown, particularly if ethnicity could have anything to do whatsoever with whatever it is that you're measuring. So it's extremely important that the sample is representative of the population. It needs to look like the population. Otherwise, when we work with that sample, our results will not be valid. Now, a variable is a characteristic of interest about each individual element of a population or sample. So let's go back to that population. We're talking about every student on campus. Well, one variable may be the gender. See, gender is a characteristic that I'm interested in. I may want to break this data down by male and female. I may be interested in their age. I may be looking for perhaps their GPA, and so forth, etc. Each one of these are variables. It's a characteristic about each individual element. In this case, the element is a person. It's a characteristic about the person, each individual person that I'm measuring. Now, we will use the word data a lot, obviously, because this is a class in data analysis. And data actually has two forms, the singular and the plural form. In the singular form, it refers to the value of the variable associated with one element of the population or sample. The value could be a numeric, it could be a word, or it could be a symbol. So a singular data value, maybe it's this first variable up here I said was gender. So the first person comes along, and let's say it's a male. Oops, male. Okay, that male, it's a word, and it's a single data value. Maybe we're also going to record their age. Maybe the person's 27. That is also a single data value. Now, data is also plural. When we talk about, typically we talk about data and use it as plural. We commonly make reference, as an example, to a or the data set. It's a collection of all the values collected. It's the entire set of all the values that we collect from each of the elements that belongs to the sample. So the first person is a male. Perhaps the second person is a female. The female is 29, and so forth, etc. All of this, the whole list of information I collected from everybody, would be the plural form of data. And again, collectively, that would make up what we more commonly refer to as the data set. Now, there's two incredibly important concepts here. The first being the parameter. Oops. There we go, the parameter. And the second being the sample statistic. Now, the parameter is a numerical value that summarizes the population. We think of the parameter as being the true value. So suppose that we were conducting a poll trying to predict the winner of an upcoming presidential election. Well, there will be, in someday in the future, when that election actually happens, there will be a true value, a true proportion of those people that are going to vote that will vote for a particular candidate. We want to know what that true value is. Well, bottom line is you can't have it, not today. You can't get it until the election occurs. So what we do is we collect some data, the sample, and from the sample we would then calculate, say, the sample proportion that was said today they're going to vote for each of the candidates. That sample gives us what we call the statistic. The statistic's numerical value summarizing the sample. So what we really want is the population parameter, but we can't have it. So we go out, look at the sample, and calculate the sample statistic. And we typically use that sample statistic to try to estimate the value from the population. We're going to use the statistic to estimate the parameter value. And hopefully, if our sample really was reasonably representative of the population, that's why it's so important to make sure we get a reasonably representative sample. If it was reasonably representative of the population, then this value for the sample statistic should be a pretty good estimate for this population parameter. If our sample doesn't look like the population, then it may not be anywhere near the parameter value. Or it could be very close simply by coincidence. We typically don't want to bet or hope for a coincidence. We want to have sound mathematical reasoning behind what we're doing to help increase the probability that our sample statistic really is a reasonable estimate for the population parameter.